right by heading osmotic pressure. That is the fourth one. Osmotic pressure. So first we can write the definition for semi-permeable membrane. What is semi-permeable membrane? We have already seen what is semi-permeable. That means a membrane which allows the passage of only solvent molecules, but not solute molecules. Such membranes are called semi-permeable membranes, SPM. They have natural semi-permeable membranes as well as synthetic or artificial semi-permeable membranes also, we can say. So you write the definition for semi-permeable membrane first. Write the definition. Say it like this. Semi-permeable membrane. We can write the definition. You put a hyphen and write the definition. A membrane which allows the passage of only solvent molecules, comma, not solute. That is a semi-permeable membrane. A membrane which allows the passage of only solvent molecules, not solute. That is called a semi-permeable membrane. We can have natural as well as synthetic or artificial semi-permeable membranes also. Understand? Examples. As the next para we can write. Next para. Pig's bladder, comma. Parchments, P-A-R-C-H-M-E-N-T, P-A-R-C-H-M-E-N-T. Etc. are natural semi-permeable membranes. Natural. Written. Then below that, cellophane. Comma, cupric, ferrocyanide membrane. Cupric ferrocyanide membrane, etc. There is a cellulose acetate also. Are synthetic semi-permeable membranes. synthetic or artificial semi-permeable membranes. So we have got a definition for a semi-permeable membrane, then examples also, natural as well as synthetic semi-permeable membranes. Okay. Now let us see the definition for osmosis. What is it? Say, a solution and solvent. Solution and pure solvent are separated by means of a semi-permeable membrane. See, you need not write this. You need not write this. See, we have, say, a semi-permeable membrane like this. Semi-permeable membrane. One side, there is the pure solvent. The other side, there is solution. So, solution and pure solvents are separated by means of a semi-permeable membrane. Then what happens? Solvent molecules will be passing from pure solvent to solution through semi-permeable membrane. And that process, that is called osmosis. So, solvent molecules, always solvent molecules pass through the semi-permeable membrane. That is from pure solvent to solution. And that passage is called, osmosis. So, as a next point, we can write osmosis. Next one is osmosis, right? Next point, osmosis. Next point, osmosis. What is meant by osmosis? Right. Write the answer. Definition. Passage of solvent molecules. Passage of solvent molecules. From pure solvent to solution. From solvent to solution. Through a semi-permeable membrane. That is called osmosis. Passage of solvent molecules from solvent to solution through a semi-permeable membrane. That is called osmosis. You know, the process of osmosis continues till the pressure on both sides become equal. So the next point is osmotic pressure. The next point is osmotic pressure. What is meant by osmotic pressure? It was our first heading. Osmotic pressure. What is osmotic pressure? Due to osmosis, we know solvent molecules pass from solvent to solution. Okay. From solvent to solution, there is passage of solvent molecules. If we apply a pressure on the side of the solution, to prevent osmosis, that is called osmotic pressure. So osmotic pressure, that is the minimum pressure, you're right. The minimum pressure to be applied, the minimum pressure to be applied on solution side, just to prevent, not more, solution side, just to prevent osmosis. That is solvent from solvent to solution. That is osmosis. Just to prevent osmosis. That is called osmotic pressure. That is osmotic pressure. So the minimum pressure to be applied on solution side, just to prevent osmosis. That's called osmotic pressure. So we have seen three terms, semi-permeable membrane, osmosis, and osmotic pressure. Osmotic pressure is a colligative property. And so it depends on colligative property. It depends on the number of solute particles in solution. As we have seen previously, the relative lowering of vapor pressure, then the elevation of boiling point, delta TB, the depression of freezing point, delta TF, and finally here, osmotic pressure. All these properties depend only on the number of solute particles in solution, and also all these are colligative properties or democratic properties. They are also known as osmotic properties also. Okay. Now let us go deep into osmotic pressure. Let us say more about osmotic pressure. You know, osmotic pressure is directly proportional to concentration. Osmotic pressure is directly proportional to concentration of the solution. Concentration is expressed in molarity. So we can say osmotic pressure of a solution is directly proportional to concentration of molarity of the solution at a given temperature. Usually say, let osmotic pressure is equal to pi. That is represented by pi. You're right. Osmotic pressure is equal to pi. Usually in the gaseous system, pressure is represented by P. We use the letter P for pressure. And here in solution, we have osmotic pressure. So to distinguish these two pressures, that is pressure of a gas, osmotic pressure of a solution. So to distinguish these two, for osmotic pressure, we use the letter pi. Osmotic pressure is equal to pi. And osmotic pressure is directly proportional to the concentration molarity at a given concentration, right? Pi directly proportional to concentration C at a given temperature, at a temperature T. Osmotic pressure pi proportional to concentration, usually molarity is taken, concentration C at temperature T. And in this relation, what is C? Where C is equal to molarity, concentration, molarity, where C is equal to concentration, molarity. We can use M also, capital M also can be used. From this, we'll get a relation, osmotic pressure relation, and it was given by Van't Hoff. You need not remember that name. That is a Nobel Prize name, Van't Hoff, the name of a scientist. From this we get pi is equal to C into R into T. See a relation like this. Relation, you write this relation. Pi is equal to C of T, where C is the molarity, concentration term, molarity. If you write M, there is nothing wrong in that. But in your text, it is given C. And it is mentioned that C is molarity. So we follow the same method, that's all. That's all. So pi is equal to CRT, where C is the concentration molarity. R is the gas constant. R is the gas constant. T is the absolute temperature, Kelvin temperature. And pi is the osmotic pressure. Pi is the osmotic pressure. From this, we can calculate the molecular mass. Do you remember? From the relative lowering of vapor pressure, we had an equation to calculate the molecular mass. From elevation of boiling point, we had an equation to calculate molecular mass of a non-volatile solute. From depression of freezing point, from that also we had a relation for the calculation of a molecular mass of a non-volatile solute. From this colligative property, osmotic pressure pi also, we can calculate molecular mass and we'll get the relation like this. We need not go into the derivation side. You simply remember the equation for molecular mass. Molecular mass MB, in all the cases, we have taken B for solute, is it not? B for solute and A for solvent. 2 for solute, 1 for solvent. The same pattern is followed. So molecular mass of the solute MB is equal to WB into RT. WB into RT by pi V. That is the equation for molecular mass. Equation for molecular mass of a non-volatile solute. So in the relation, MB is equal to WB RT by pi V. Here, where MB, you right? MB is equal to molecular mass of a solute. Molecular mass of a solute. MB is equal to molecular mass of solute. Written, WB is equal to mass of a solute in gram. Mass of a solute. Mass of a solute. You take the mass of the solute always in gram. WB, mass of the solute. Then R. R is the, below this you write, below this. R is the gas constant. No, gas constant has several terms. Several terms you have studied. But here, you study only two terms for the gas constant. That is liter atmosphere per Kelvin per mole, or the other one, there is one more, that is for R, that is liter bar per Kelvin per mole. So R is equal to 0.082 liter atmosphere per Kelvin per mole. Liter atmosphere, ATM, ATM, not the other ATM, this is atmosphere, atmosphere. 0.082, 1 is there. I'm deleting that, omitting that. You just remember only this much. 0.082 liter atmosphere per Kelvin per mole. Per Kelvin per mole. Per Kelvin per mole. Instead of atmosphere, you may be given pressure in terms of bar, the unit bar. You know, atmosphere is there. Bar is there, not the other bar, here bar, pressure bar. Bar is here, then anaminada, mala, okay. So bar is here, there is a centimeter, there is millimeter, there is Pascal, all these things are here. But you compulsorily you remember only these values. Or 0.083 liter bar per Kelvin per mole. Per Kelvin per mole. Compulsory, it is compulsory, I say. You remember only these two. That is easy. That is easy for solving the problems. That is easy for you. Okay. Then, that is the value of R. Then what else? T. T is the absolute temperature. That is a Kelvin temperature. Temperature on the Kelvin scale. If it is given on Kelvin scale, there is no problem. If it is a degree Celsius, then what you have to do? You must add 273.15 or minimum 273 as an approximation. As an approximation, you can add 273. And to be more exact, it is 273.15. Then pi is equal to osmotic pressure. Pressure, what is the unit here? What is the unit? The unit will be either atmosphere or bar. There is no much difference. Not 8 to 2, not 8 to 3. There is no much difference. So the unit of osmotic pressure will be atmosphere or bar. You write the unit accordingly. Okay. So it is either atmosphere or bar. Then V. V is equal to volume. And what is the unit of a volume here? Vidur. Vidur is not there.
Sir.
What is the unit of a unit of volume here? You look at the R value. You look at the R value. From that you'll get the unit for volume. What is the unit? Achu, what is the unit for volume? That is it is the liter atmosphere, liter bar. So volume in liter. That is in liter. Liter. That is the unit. Unit is very important because when you substitute the values, depending on the units, the final values will be changing. Okay. So you always express the volume in liter, then R value in liter atmosphere or a liter bar. Liter atmosphere or liter bar. If it is a liter atmosphere, then the unit of osmotic pressure will be atmosphere. If the unit of R is liter bar, then the unit of osmotic pressure will be bar units. So these are the terms you have to remember. we have MB is equal to WB RT by pi V. So from this also we can calculate molecular mass of a molecular mass of a solute. You are saying the osmotic pressure. Let us solve a simple problem. You write down, you please write down the problem. Problems, only problems will be asked for the examination. Write the problem. Okay, right. 200 centimeters cube problem. This is not lead. 200 centimeter cube, cubic centimeter, cc. CC is the same as ml. CC is the same as ml. What are the same in quantity? Either you can use a centimeter cube, cubic centimeter, CC, or it is same as ml, milliliter. Both are the same. Okay. So 200 centimeter cube of an aqueous solution of an aqueous solution, water solution. An aqueous solution of a protein, an aqueous solution of a protein, contains 1.26 gram of protein, contains 1.26 gram of protein, 1.26 gram of protein. Osmotic pressure of the solution, osmotic pressure of the solution at 300 pressure, at 300 Kelvin, at 300 Kelvin is 2.57 into 10 raised to negative 3 bar, full stop. Calculate molecular mass of the solute. Calculate molecular mass of the solute, the protein. What is molecular mass of the solute? Solute means the protein. So here we have osmotic pressure. So to calculate the molecular mass, we have to make use of the molecular, the osmotic pressure equation. You write the equation first. Equation for molecular mass. All of you are there? No? So write MB is equal to, molecular mass is equal to WB into RT by pi V. We have to calculate molecular mass MB. So you write the equation first. Then you substitute. C equal to WB, mass of the solute protein in gram, 1.26 into R. Achu, what is the value of R to be taken here? You look at the osmotic pressure, unit of osmotic pressure, bar. So
0.0.
R value should be liter bar, 0.083. So much liter bar. Into temperature, absolute temperature is given. It is directly given, Kelvin temperature, and that is 300. Directly given by pi, 2.57 into 10 raised to negative 3. So much bar. Into volume V. V should be in which unit? Vidur, you say.
200.
What is the volume? Oh, Vidur is not responding. Emmanuel, you say.
200.
Volume should be in liter. And what is the volume? In liter. At the beginning I told you liter atmosphere. So liter 200 divided by 1000. 1000 ml is equal to 1 liter. 1000 cc is equal to 1 liter. So you convert this volume into liter. Do you follow what I say?
Yes, sir.
Liter atmosphere. Liter atmosphere. Here liter bar. Liter bar. So the volume should be in liter. You study like that. You always convert the volume into liter. You need not study the other units of R. You study only this unit. 0.082 liter atmosphere or 0.083 liter bar per Kelvin per mole. Remember that value only. And the volume should be in liter. It is always liter. If it is cc by 1000, if it is ml by 1000. And this is equal to, you simplify it slowly, taking time. And what will be the unit? Molecular mass. Manuel?
Doing, sir.
So much gram per mole. Gram per mole. Or so much U. U also will do. U will do. Or so much gram per mole. That is the molecular mass for the protein. So only such a simple question should be asked for the examination. So we have seen osmosis, osmotic pressure, semi-permeable membrane, and equation for calculating molecular mass from the osmotic pressure. We have the relation MB is equal to WBRT by pi V. And in that, care must be taken. R is either in liter atmosphere or in liter bar. If it is so, the pressure will be either atmosphere or bar. And the volume will be always in liter. Volume is always in liter. Okay. So that care must be taken when you solve the problems. Okay. So that's about the introduction part of the osmotic pressure. Now we have to see three types of solutions. That is isotonic solutions, then hypertonic solutions, and hypotonic solutions. Hypotonic solutions. Three types of solutions we have to see. And get to see the application of osmosis also. Biology students know it well, application of osmosis. Majority of the biology students are not here. They know the application of osmosis in plants, in our body, etc. We know the application of osmosis. So we have to see two more points here. One is three types of solutions, isotonic, then hypertonic, and hypotonic solutions. Then the application of it. And finally, we have to see reverse osmosis process. That is the modern technique. Reverse osmosis process that is used for desalination of a brackish water. Desalination, removal of salt from seawater. By that, we can prepare very pure water, drinking water from seawater. Drinking water can be prepared from seawater by the reverse osmosis process. So these are the points we have to see, and more details we can see in the coming Yes. So by that we can finish this chapter. So my intention